Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back for the boys game tonight. And Derek, before we start the boys game, I hear that Shiloh is going to be one of the top teams in the conference.
Yeah,
right?
I think so. Before the season started, I knew P. Ridge was going to have a really strong team. And then I found out Shiloh played P. Ridge and beat him by about 25 points. So Shiloh is definitely one of the top contenders, I would think, in the league. They've lost some games on the year, but they played some really good competition. I know they played Jonesboro. They've played Pulaski Academy. They went down and played in that Northeast Arkansas tournament over the Christmas break, and I don't know if I know they won their first game. I don't know what else happened after that, but they're going to be a good team and a good test for us tonight.
Well, they're going to do our national anthem. We're going to join them, and hopefully you can hear it as we go here. I know those that are watching, I wish you could hear the national anthem where they're singing the Prager of Alma Mater now. And I know that just part of our webcast, sometimes hard to pick that up, but our choir does a great job. Miss Katie Young, she's our leader of our choir, and she's been here for several years and does a great job.
I'm really surprised the band and the choir are both here tonight. We haven't even started school back, but they're still here, so they're showing their support for the basketball teams. It's always good to see.
Yep, they'll all be there in the morning, though, won't they, Mr. Dugan?
We will all be there.
On my way out, I saw several alumni. I saw Beeks and Sainer and a couple of the old football players, David Lehman, and there was one or two others down there that were sitting down there here, probably out of school, chance to come back home.
Well, those college kids that get a month Christmas break.
they're getting cabin fever, too.
Yeah.
Well, Hunter Pauling. He's a guard, sophomore, 5'11". Jared Shenave, he's a forward. He's a senior, 6 foot. Taylor Thompson, he's a 6'5 senior. And Darian Harris, a junior. And if I heard right, they are starting two seniors, two juniors, and a sophomore. Prairie Grove tonight, a little bit different starting lineup than we saw before the Christmas break. Marcus Patterson, double zero.
Number three, Cameron Dowdy.
Cameron Dowdy. He was big in our first game of the season against Lincoln. And now getting to start tonight, Ty Tice, he's a sophomore. Delton Rhodes. And Jordan Baumgartner, we were here earlier setting up tonight, or this afternoon, Derek, and he was begging for some love over the webcast. So
if he plays well enough, we'll give it to him, right?
That's right. That's what I told him.
Got to earn it.
And he's worked hard and earned him a starting position on the team. And I imagine Coach Ed will go 7 or 8 deep because he's got battles on the that can come off the bench. He's also got Peyton Sims that can come off the bench. So he's got players that can come on and help. If you're watching tonight, please go to our comment page as we start the boys game and let us know where you're watching from. There's the tip. Shiloh's going to control it. That's number one, Pauling. Number four, Ryder Anderson. Chenier, is that the way you say that?
I think so.
He's number two, Jared Chenier.
Well, that's what we're going to go with.
Nice ball movement by Shiloh. Gets it into Taylor Thompson for the easy basket. Shiloh strikes first and leads 2-0. There's Cameron Dowdy. He thought about that long shot. Ty Tice with the ball. Guarded very tight there by Anderson. Delton Rhodes. Got Baumgartner down there working inside, trying to find something going on in there. Sets a nice screen. Delton Rhodes goes strong into the hole. He's going to get a foul by Taylor Thompson.
Well, and I was talking to Coach Ed earlier too, Lynn, and he had 25 in the last game that we played against Batesville over at, was it Harrison?
Or was it? I believe it was, yep.
So he is coming off probably his best offensive game. That's a good start for him.
And he misses his first free throw.
You know, he struggled at the line against Gravett that night that we won up there at Gravett. Missed a lot of free throws, but made some big baskets for us down the stretch to get us that win.
Rhodes makes 1 of 2. Derek, if you can, do your little circles on the free throws and see if we can keep up with how many, you know, where we go tonight, because that's 1 of 2.
Yeah, I think Delton's guarding Darian Harris, which is their best player.
Nice block there. So, yeah, he's getting, looks like he's going to have Darian Harris.
Well, Delton's used to guarding high-scoring players. He did it against the Lee kid from Clarksville last year, Regionals, who was the state championship MVP.
We did it. He did a really good job on him.
He did.
Especially first half. Now Shiloh goes 1 of 2 from the line, and they lead 3-1.
Well, this is another one of those games, Lynn, where we're going to be undersized. That's a good pass from Rhodes to Baumgartner there for an easy bucket.
Baumgartner, there's your first basket.
That was a good one.
And that was a good one. Good work in there inside. Like I said, he's not that tall, but he plays big. He plays really big. And there he is. They're going to get him for a push there. Nice move there, and there's a long three there by Anderson. Now Rhodes,
that's a foul. I didn't think they were going to call it.
If he hadn't gone to the floor, they may not have called
may
it.
May not have. That was a little bit of a delay on that call, but actually both officials ended up calling it.
Derek, Delton now 2 of 3 from the line. And the Tigers take a 5-3 lead. And Prairie Grove is doing the box and one here. Coach Ed seems pleased with the effort there by Patterson.
Well, the intent is make somebody else beat you. And sometimes teams are able to do that, sometimes they're not. We'll see how it works out tonight. But Harris is definitely their best player offensively. And he's just a junior, but he's got good size. He can shoot it from anywhere. We'll see if Delton can do a good job on him.
Nice move. And now the loose ball picked up by Baumgartner. Delton Rhodes thought about the three. Now he gets it out to Baumgartner. And Patterson pass it out to Rhodes for three. Bottom. Delton Rhodes now with 6 points, and the Tigers lead 8-3. I'm a little surprised at the beginning of this game, but it's a nice start for the Tigers.
Very good start. Couldn't ask for a better start, really. We've not let Harris even shoot the ball, so we'll kind of keep track of what he's able to do.
Well, I imagine Coach Hester will call a timeout here in a minute and make some adjustments to do something different than what's going on right now. I don't know if they anticipated this box and one. Nice move. Nice cut move there by Anderson. Also a nice assist. Cameron Dowdy.
Yeah, that's something that happens sometimes when you change defenses. You lose responsibilities, and teams end up with sometimes an easier shot than what you'd like for them to, but hopefully the box and one pays off for you and you're able to shut down their best score.
Andrew Daniels coming in now for Sinier. So far, no turnovers in the game thus far, Derek.
Just one for Shiloh. They actually turned it over. I don't remember if they threw it away or we stole it. But I know they did get one.
It was inside. Yep,
okay.
It was.
Oh, there we go.
There's the jinx that I talk about. Ty Tice may have gotten away with a push there, but Daniels, who just came to the game, gets his first bucket. 8-7, Tigers lead. Cameron Dowdy with a shot. He's going to get fouled. Foul will be on Daniels.
Lynn, they call that on number 11. Do you see a number 11 out on
Yeah, Daniel.
Andrew Daniels. Sorry. I wrote him down as number 10. Okay. My mistake.
Dowdy misses the first free throw. 1 of 2. And the Tigers hold a 9-7 lead. Well, Daniel has come in and given him a little bit of a spark. Offensively and defensively. Wow. That's why you probably on him with that little turnaround jumper. Darian Harris gets his first basket, comes at the 3:30 mark.
Well, and the key to that one was
they're going to call Baumgartner for travel.
The key to that possession was Harris was able to catch the ball at the mid lane, and he's got the size advantage on Delton, where if he catches it right there, he's probably going to get the shot off, and he's a good enough player. He's usually going to make that one. Got to make sure we work hard to keep the ball out of his hands.
You know, Coach Ed has done this at various times, gone to the box and won. I know a few years ago he had a young man that he would use to do that. He finds a player, good defensive player, and he says, okay, we're gonna try to slow their best guy, and like you said, make somebody else beat us.
Yeah, your son might have done that a couple times. I don't remember if we ever stuck him on somebody or not.
Once or
probably
twice.
Did, yeah.
Once or twice. He's tough. Darian Harris is, I mean, when he gets the ball, I can see he is difficult to, and this is the one thing that when you're doing this box and one like this is the fouls. You got to be careful. And, you know, if he gets out of the quarter with only one, that would be impressive. You don't want to get two. Turnaround jump by Thompson, no good. Rebound by Patterson.
You know, not only that, but Delton's got to exert a lot of energy defensively to kind of shut down Harris. But then we also need Delton's offensive scoring. We got to find some ways to get him some rest every now and then.
Well, the one thing is that we know from the Lincoln game, we have other people who can score. And there's one of them right there, Cameron. He gets it inside to Patterson. Nice work there by Patterson.
Yeah, nice job of head faking with the shot fake. Got the defender up in the air and was able to get the foul. At first, I thought he was going to hesitate and it was going to cost him, but paid off for us if he can hit these free throws. And that's Harris's first foul, too. Well, then we've definitely gotten to the free throw line early and often in this first quarter.
See, they're sitting at five team fouls. Anybody in trouble, or they all got one?
They've all got one. And actually, I guess I missed one because I've only got them down for four fouls. Try to figure out who that was.
Patterson gets both, and the Tigers lead 11-9. Well, now you can see part of the strategy is get it to him, bringing the ball down. Nice ball movement. They're number 24s in the game. That's Kyle Bates. What would you say, Derek?
Let's go with Bate.
Bate.
Sounds better, I think.
Yep. I may be bold enough to ask one of these Shiloh people here in a minute.
Well, that's two fouls there on Ty Tice. So it looks like Battles is going to come in the game. And two fouls on Rhodes, too. Beat.
Coach Josh Floyd's just below us here. He says it's Beat. Harris at the line. Well, that's Delton's second foul.
Yeah, we didn't want to see that. He's been working hard and done a pretty good job in the first quarter, but two fouls is going to be tough.
Coming into the game is number five, Derek Arguello, and Battles both coming into the game. Just two turnovers in the first quarter for Prairie Grove so far, and I was really worried about that tonight.
Yeah, Shiloh sometimes will pressure in the full court. They haven't shown that yet, and we haven't really been careless with the ball yet, so if we can continue to protect the ball, we're going to have a good chance in this game. Playing smart right now.
All tied up 11. Battles, drives. Ball's blocked. That's a good, strong move. I like to see that. Go to the baseline. You got to take it.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that.
But Battles probably standing at, Battles stands at 5'9". He went in against some pretty tall young men, and that's a long three by Dowdy.
Baumgartner.
Oh. Jordan Baumgartner with the putback in. He's playing hard, playing strong. Oh, my gosh. That's why you do a box and one on him, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess so, and I really didn't see if we were still doing it right there. But
heck, he was in Kevin Morton range.
Yeah, yeah, he pulled up from about 25 on that one.
Patterson goes strong to the hole, doesn't get the foul. Now Harris just
leave two guys on him.
Somebody's got to be open. That's what he's thinking to himself. Nice defense there, transition-wise,
yeah,
by Prairie Grove.
Well, we are boxing him. Arguello's on him now.
They're going to get him for a hand check there. I heard, oh, my gosh, over from the Prairie Grove side.
Well, it looked like to me, Lynn, they called a hand check, but then they're giving him two shots. Normally on a hand check, that's when somebody's dribbling
three,
the ball.
But he was behind the three-point line.
Was he? They may be giving him three. And who'd they call the foul on, Lynn? So did they get battles on that, I think?
They get battles or
I think they did call 32.
They got battles.
Okay.
They got battles for that. I thought Arguello was all over it. So they give him two shots there.
Well, as good of a job as we did on Harris for the first half of that first quarter, he's really exploded here for the last two or three minutes.
3.5 minutes, he got 9 points. Well, Prairie Grove played a fantastic, say, first, what do we play?
Six minutes,
and then Shiloh really kind of poured on. But Prairie Grove's within striking distance, 16-13. Let's take a quick commercial break. We'll be back for the second quarter.
How do you tell someone that they're special?
Flowers and friends.
How do you tell someone that they're loved?
Flowers and friends.
How do you tell someone happy anniversary?
Flowers and friends.
And how do you express your deepest sympathy?
Flowers and friends.
In Prairie Grove, when your message needs to be expressed with flowers, be it fresh-cut flowers or one-of-a-kind silk arrangement, think Flowers and Friends or drive by 114 East Buchanan, or you can call them at 846-2137. Flowers and Friends. Flowers, gifts, and more with that hometown touch.
Good first quarter, Prairie Grove trailing 13-16. Both teams have fouled, Prairie Grove with six, Shiloh with five. Who do we have with two? We have Tice and Rhodes. Original starting lineup back to start the second quarter.
It'll be interesting to see if Delton is still on Harris, because we really do not need Delton to pick up that third foul before halftime.
If you're watching, please let us go to the comment page on PGTigersOnline.com. And there's a turnover there by Cameron Dowdy. And that's what we can't do. We cannot be careless like that. That was unforced.
Yeah, it was a no-look turnover. He wasn't even looking at the guy he was passing to and ended up throwing it to a Shiloh player that was sitting over there on the bench.
Still got Delton there. My holy, that's when you can do a turnaround jumper from
22 feet.
Yeah,
didn't even look like he had a good vision at the goal.
Well,
the problem, Lynn, we let him catch the ball. Got to keep the ball out of his hands because he's capable of scoring from anywhere on the floor if he catches it.
Well, the adjustment they made is, they let him start getting it to begin with to bring it down, and we're not contesting it
right
at that point.
Yeah, it'll be key. Once he gives the ball up, everybody's going to have to help Delton to keep him from getting the ball back.
Long three. That's might be a tad out of his range. Nice save there by Delton, and now Dowdy drives the lane and gets the basket.
Well, that was a good save over there, and then a good cut to the basket by Dowdy, and good finish.
Everyone did a good job there. Delton to save it. Got it to Baumgartner. Baumgartner fed a flying through the lane Cameron Dowdy, and Tigers stay within four. Nice. Nice shot there by Anderson, and good defense by Baumgartner.
Baumgartner was in good position, but that was just a better finish by Anderson and jumping up and making the shot.
Tice throws up a three, no good. Baumgartner knocks it out. Delton Rhodes recovers. Wow, why would you? If I could shoot like that, I'd never think about passing. But he finally missed one. Now Delton Rhodes with a chance for a three. Bottom. Oh. And that was a much-needed three. Closed
yes,
the gap 21-18.
We were kind of in a danger zone right there. It was in danger of getting away from us a little bit. Big three-point shot by Delton.
Oh, Cameron may have gotten away one. And a nice three-point shot by Anderson. Anderson now with 7 points. Shiloh leads 24-18. Whoa. And he got away. I wish they had called him for the.
Yeah. Would have saved him from getting the foul, right?
For the walk there instead of the charge. That's Patterson's first. Now battles. And number 33 into the game now. That is
Jacob Storley, Lynn.
Is that Storley?
I don't have an updated roster since football season. I need to change that. But, yeah, that is Jacob Storley. It's the first time we've actually seen him in the game all season long, I guess.
Well, Storley's in the game, and you got battles now. Let's see Tice and Baumgartner there. Wow. Harris got hit there at the end.
Boy, they look good when he shoots it, don't they?
Yeah, he does. Battles is standing out of bounds. Prairie Grove now with 5 turnovers. And the last 3 have come pretty quick.
Yeah, and I don't think any of the 5 have been forced by Shiloh. It's just been us being a little careless with the ball.
That one right there, what happened was we passed it and Battles was standing on the line whenever the pass got to him. Now Patterson beats the Shiloh defense back and gets the quick bucket. You know, as good as Shiloh is, and they are good, Prairie Grove is hanging tough and keeping it close. We are at the 3:45 mark here in the first half. Shot rebounded by Harris. Gets it into Taylor. When Harris knows there's 3 guys on him, he knows somebody's got to be open.
Yeah, that was an immediate rebound and pass over to
Battles
Thompson.
For 3, no good. Now Patterson gets it knocked away. Oh, no. Delton, nice move by Rhodes.
Oh, good sidestep.
That was a nice move by Mr. Delton Rhodes.
A smart play because the Shiloh defender was trying to take a charge. That would have been Delton's 3rd foul if they would have called it. Good job of avoiding the contact.
That was a very good move.
Really was. Well, that's the shot we're trying to make them take.
Beat with the shot there, and then Thompson with the rebound, and that's what we got to do. Yeah. They miss it. We can't give them 2 chances.
Exactly. You got to find bodies.
They're giving Battles fits over there in that corner. Battles, it's not going to be a 1-1 yet. Battles foul. Marcus Patterson comes out. Delton's going to come out. And that's
Landon Allen getting into the game.
Landon Allen coming in. The field goal kicker from the football team. Great field goal kicker. Stanford could have used him last night.
Alabama may need him Monday night.
Oh, now you're getting
sorry.
Too close to
I'm
home.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Nice save by Cameron and timeout by Coach Ed. Yeah, Bama could have used him again.
And the kicking game has cost a lot of teams this year.
Oh, yeah.
It really has.
While we're on a break talking a little football, yesterday Georgia played for field goal and lost. Stanford played for field goal and lost. And Oklahoma State, they won, but they were less than a half a foot from scoring.
Yeah. I was surprised they didn't just try to sneak it in.
And they run, they snap it, go back 5 yards, and say, we're going to kick a field goal. It worked.
I don't trust kickers. I mean, even in the NFL, you just don't trust them. I heard a guy talking today on ESPN. He was saying he would use a first-round draft pick on a quality kicker out of college because you think about how many games are won and lost. It all comes down to that kick sometimes.
Well, one last thing about kickers, and that is some of these guys are good until the pressure's on, and that's what we saw yesterday.
Yep.
Prairie Grove with another turnover, and that was, again, Dowdy's getting that ball there on the inside. Or was that, I guess that was Landon over here.
Yeah, Landon. Yeah. We tried to get it to him. It got knocked away, but, you know, when you're a post player, when the ball's coming to you, sometimes if you just wait on it, it never gets there.
Now, Landon, you know, Derek, you may not remember, but back in the 80s, well, Georgetown started wearing the shirts underneath with a short sleeve shirt.
Uh-huh.
I think Landon may be the first player I've ever seen with a long sleeve shirt underneath.
I've actually seen it one time. There was a player for Oklahoma 3 or 4 years ago, shooter. I don't remember his name. Crocker might have been his name. Oh,
did
my
you see
goodness.
That was an NBA 3-point range for Harris, now with 15 points and stretching the Shiloh lead to 9.
Yeah, we're in danger zone again. Battles again stepped out of bounds.
That's twice that Battles. There's that thick line you're talking about.
Yeah,
there.
Well, at that time, if you do step on it when you're in bounds, they will call it. Oh, there we go. Harris tried to rifle that one in there, and Landon Allen did a good job of stealing it. Delton Rhodes and Ty Tosh checking back into the game for the Tigers. They replace Arguello. And it looks like Chad Battles getting a little bit of a breather over there. Now Taylor Thompson checking back in for the Saints. He replaces Jared Chenier. 31-22, Shiloh with the lead. 1:15 to play in the second quarter. And now Dowdy is manned up on Harris.
Boy, that 3-point would have been a dagger right there. We've got to keep it down to single digits. Very important. Ty Tice trying the baseline, now out the road. Inside, there's the sophomore.
Oh, that was a good look there for Storley. He just fading away a little bit, and it rolled right off the rim.
And who are they going to get there? Maybe it's Storley. I hope it's Storley and not Rhodes on that.
I think they did get Jacob. Well, that actually was a good foul for us because Harris had made that pass off to Thompson. He was going to get an easy layup. At least we're going to make him earn it at the free throw line.
I don't know what's more of a guarantee, him from the free throw line or Thompson underneath.
Yeah, you might be right about that.
If you're watching, please go to the comments page on PGTigersOnline.com. Let us know where you're watching from tonight. Oh, he missed one.
The jinx is back in effect.
That's that good jinx. There's Rhodes for three and bottom.
Oh, Delton has been hot from over there on that corner.
He likes
his third three-pointer.
And he's sitting at 14 points tonight. 32-25. Boy, if we could get out of here.
Yeah,
right
big
here.
Stop right here. Keep it out of Harris's hands.
Hard to do.
Yeah, it is.
Dowdy's going to turn it over right there with 2 seconds left. Tried to take off running with it before we got it. You know, in the previous game, you talked about 5 turnovers per quarter. We're sitting at 4 turnovers per.
Right. And I think anytime you're playing a half court defensive team, which is what Shiloh's doing, you'd like to see those turnovers stay in the single digits. And we're just being too careless with the ball right now and giving Shiloh a chance to put this thing into double digits before halftime. You know, one thing on that play down there is it's not just the guy that's guarding Harris that's got to do a good job defensively, because that time they screened Cameron, who was guarding Harris. And whenever that happens, we've got to have somebody else step up and deny the pass to Harris before he's able to get it. and give Cameron that opportunity to get back to Harris. And that time there was no help defense.
Mr. Orange had that so loud, I don't know a single word you just said.
Yeah, I don't either.
Nice play.
That was a good look right there.
Well, after the first half, first quarter, Prairie Grove only down 3, now down 9. Kept it single digits.
Kept in single digits, but what I was talking about earlier, Lynn, is it's not just the guy that's guarding Harris that has to do a good job. Anytime there's a screen set for Harris, we have to have somebody else step up and deny the ball to Harris. And it didn't happen that last time down the floor, and that's what enabled Darian to catch the ball and finish down there. But, yeah, we're still in striking distance here. We've got to make some adjustments, tighten things up defensively. We're doing a good job on the most part defensively as far as forcing other people to take shots. The key is we're not getting those rebounds when those guys are missing it. And Taylor Thompson's done a nice job of getting some easy baskets off the offensive rebounds.
Well, a couple of things just noticing here. Harris sitting at 18 points. And we're only at halftime.
Yeah, 18
points. Rhodes was 14 himself. The other thing, just noticed down here, we were talking earlier about the former Prairie Grove players. I see Ashton Absher down there talking to Coach Proud.
It's like a class reunion here tonight.
Typically is this time of the year. Mm-hmm. Kids are home from school. They haven't had to go back yet.
College kids have nothing else to do.
Yeah,
no homework.
I saw our cameraman's daughter out earlier in the foyer as well. And kind of like Julie Rutherford said earlier, once a Prairie Grove Tiger, always a Prairie Grove Tiger. Good to have them back.
And this could be dance-off time now with our mascots. Remember over at Huntsville a few weeks ago, there was a dance-off between the Eagle and the Tiger, so here's the Tiger's turn.
I'm not sure what they would come out with.
Yeah.
I'm not going to get – oh, wow, here we go.
We've added some moves over the Christmas break.
It looks like our Tiger has worked on this a little bit. I think this whole mascot thing is a new phenomenon. I've seen it not just at our games, but I'm starting to see it at various other events.
I'm sure these shallow people really appreciate that.
Nice job there.
Oh, man.
Well, let's take a couple commercial breaks here, and we'll be back with you here in the next 2 or 3 minutes for the second half.
PG Telco is the proud sponsor of PGTigersOnline.com, where you can find out all the very latest of what's going on with all the sports teams right here in Prairie Grove. But PG Telco is more, a lot more. They offer phone, internet, long-distance services, and bundles, making it all affordable. And that includes DirecTV. For your home or office, staying connected to the fast-paced world is as easy as calling PG Telco. Call 846-7200. That's 846-7200. PG Telco, built on community, focused on progress. Ozark Delight Lollipops are America's number one fundraising lollipop. We produce our lollipops the old-fashioned way in small batches, ensuring flavor intensity to the last lick. Mass-produced, machine-made lollipops are simply inferior, and you and your customers can taste the difference. From the production to customer service to everything in between, Ozark's Delight does it right. So whether you're ordering for the next fundraising project or just need some of your favorite flavors, we're here to help. Click our website, ozarkdelight.com, or call us toll-free at 1-800-334-8 991. Whether in sports or banking, competition is healthy for a community. If you consider all the choices you have in banking today, the Bank of Fayetteville stands out. The founders of the Bank of Fayetteville realize the importance of giving back to the community, not only for the Tigers on the field tonight, but for the future Tigers to come. The Bank of Fayetteville believes that the folks of Prairie Grove have great potential, and they have that one goal in mind to help you reach that potential. You see, with this thought process in mind, the community wins. The Bank of Fayetteville, banking on your potential. There's been a Davis at the counter of Sterling Drugs since before most of us were born. As a matter of fact, Sterling Drugs been at the same location in Prairie Grove since 1918. And while a lot has changed in the medical field, quality customer care is not one of them at Sterling Drug. You'll find the latest in all prescriptions explained to you by Gary Davis. He's been doing it for nearly 30 years. As a matter of fact, Gary's only going to charge you for the medication. His experience, he's going to throw that in for free. Keeping you healthy since 1918. Sterling Drug, 125 East Buchanan in Prairie Grove. Proud sponsors of Prairie Grove Athletics. How do you tell someone that they're special?
Flowers and friends.
How do you tell someone that they're loved?
Flowers and friends.
How do you tell someone happy anniversary?
Flowers and friends.
And how do you express your deepest sympathy?
Flowers and friends.
In Prairie Grove, when your message needs to be expressed with flowers, be it fresh-cut flowers or one-of-a-kind silk arrangement, think Flowers and Friends or drive by 114 East Buchanan, or you can call them at 846-2137. Flowers and Friends. Flowers, gifts, and more with that hometown touch. Where in Prairie Grove can you go to get your gas, grab a tank of propane, a bag of ice, your favorite snack and a soda drink, have your breakfast or lunch prepared fresh, made to order, wash that down with your favorite drink, and follow that with a hand-dipped ice cream? There's only one place that I know of that comes close to all of that in Prairie Grove. Locally owned and operated, it has to be Frederick's One Stop. And did I mention the coffee breaks in the afternoon where all the world's problems are solved? Only at Frederick's One Stop. Proud to be sponsors of Prairie Grove Tiger Athletics. What does it take to win a President's Award from Ford? It takes hard work. It takes dedication and teamwork. A lot of the same ingredients that every single coach looks for to build a championship team. Well, Lewis Ford won the President's Award because they delivered award-winning service before, during, and after each and every sale. That's the standard that's been set at all Lewis dealerships. Whether it's Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, or Jeep, Lewis Automotive is delivering award-winning service since 1947. Lewis Automotive says, "Go Tigers!" PG Telco, built on community, focused on progress. But what does that mean to you? It means that you get to keep up with all your sporting events associated with Prairie Grove Athletics on a website furnished and maintained by PG Telco. It means that the folks at PG Telco have an interest in you, your kids, your school, and your community. And they're focused on progress. They're committed to bringing you the very latest in technology for your home or your office for telephone, internet, long distance, or DirecTV. Think PG Telco. Built on community, focused on progress.
All right, we're back, almost on for the second half. And Derek, you want to go through some stats real quick? Turnovers, I can see here, is 8-2.
Yeah.
Big difference in the game.
Unforced turnovers have been a key. Offensive rebound has been a key for us. And Darian Harris for Shiloh has 18 points. He leads them and leads all scorers. Ryder Anderson with 7 points, Taylor Thompson with 6, Andrew Daniels with 2, and Hunter Pauling with 1 point. For the Tigers, Delton Rhodes leads us with 14 points, 3-for-4 at the free throw line. Marcus Patterson with 4, Dowdy with 3, and Jordan Baumgartner with 4. And Lynn, I don't think we shot any free throws in the second quarter. We did a really good job of getting there in the first quarter and seemed like we were less aggressive with the ball in the second quarter. We need to find that again if we want to have a chance to win this game.
And we're 6-of-8 from the line, which is pretty good.
Yeah, 75% you can live with.
Rhodes with for 3 and bottom, and that's a good start for our second half. Rhodes now with 17 points. Prairie Grove pulls within 6, and that's a good way to start the second half. Bringing the ball down is Pauling for the Saints. And they're going to get Delton with a quick, cheap foul. But a foul it is. And that's 3 on Delton. I wonder if Coach Froud, how much longer he can leave Delton on him. Cameron Dowdy goes up, gets the rebound. There's no doubt Delton is, you know, very good on him, but Baumgartner, can he put it his best impression of Lou Alcindor there? Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, I guess.
Well, Kareem did a sky hook. That was just a hook. There was no sky involved in that shot.
There was no sky hook in that at all, was there? Nice pass there to Janier from, I didn't see who made the pass, but I think it was number four, Anderson, made a nice pass to Janier. Rhodes, he's going to take it, pull up, jumper, no good. Thompson with the rebound. And there's another fast break. Oh! Anderson tried to get a little fancy there, but luckily Patterson was there to knock that away.
Tigers, yeah, we kind of got lucky there because we did not get back on defense, and we were fortunate that they weren't able to handle the pass and finish with the layup because they had an open look there.
I wonder if that they're up by 10. I wonder if that's something they saw because they've done that twice now. They may have picked that up at halftime and talked about it.
Yeah, and that's one of the things when you change your defense and you go to a box and one, sometimes your responsibilities, especially on out-of-bounds plays, you're going to be out of position just a little bit. There's Hunter Pollen gets away with a hand check. Good grief. Wow.
Baumgartner, I like the way he played that right there. You know, he went up there, blocked by Thompson, got his rebound, went back up strong, and then I believe that was number two, Chenier, picking up the foul.
Yeah, they did call it on Chenier. This is Baumgartner's first free throws of the game. Can't let this thing get away from us. It's a 10-point lead right now. We got to keep this in single digits.
Baumgartner makes one of two. Prairie Grove now 7 of 10 from the line. I've noticed that Pauling doesn't take a lot of shots. And I've also noticed that Thompson is a force inside.
Well, he's got 10 points, and all five of them have just been right around the basket, little layup type shots. He's a big body down there.
Nice recovery there by Patterson. There's, oh, Delton threw it right to Harris. They're going to call that. I hope they call it two shots. Double zero, Patterson with the foul. I would thought for a minute there Rhodes was going to pick up his fourth.
Yeah, it's probably good that they didn't call that on Delton. I think Coach Ed's a little upset with the official there because she was trailing the play, and on a turnover like that, she's supposed to be down on the baseline, but she was trailing the play and a little bit out of position. Probably there was probably contact there, but you'd like to see the officials at least in position to make that call. .20 points for Harris, Lynn. He's done a really good job, even though we've tried to put one guy on him. One guy may not be enough for him.
Coach Ed getting a little upset over there. They're not running the offense the way he wants to. He's even barking at his leading scorer, Rhodes, saying, Delton, where are you, Val?
Yeah, we're going to need Delton, and Delton's done a really good job. He's done it on both ends tonight, but he's got to have some help too. Well, Shiloh's gotten a lot more physical out on the perimeter, it looks like, in this half.
Nice move by the sophomore, Ty Tice. Nice block, and he's on the line there. Nice block there by Thompson. But, you know, I like to see a guy, let's see, you know, Ty stands at 5'8", and he went in there strong. You know, I mean, wasn't afraid.
Yeah, it didn't pay off for him, but he was not scared to go in there. Sometimes those things will pay off. You either draw a foul or maybe somebody else gets a rebound for you and puts in an easy basket, but you like to see aggressive plays.
Well, one of the things, there's Delt, turnaround, jump 15-footer, good. Rhodes now with 19.
Well, Delton, he's matched Harris point for point. Just we've got to have some other guys step up and give us some offensive.
Nice steal there. He was in good position there. Battles to get the steal. And now Prairie Grove trailing by 11. Now they're going to get Harris for a foul. Harris is second. Boy, that would be helpful, but you'd have to go at him every play to get him in trouble.
Yeah.
And that may not be too bright.
Yeah, it might not be.
Prairie Grove hanging around, only down by 11. There's Tice. He comes around. Looks like he's got to get it in. Dowdy.
And now Delton's out of the game, so we're going to see if somebody else can step up and make some baskets for us.
There's Baumgartner. Get the retreat. Turnover both sides. End of the game is Brad Harton giving Delton some rest. Harden, nice pass to Baumgartner. Now Ty Tice for three. No good. Now Tice gets, you know what? That was a nice attempt to save by Tice there.
Came all the way across the floor to try to get the ball in force.
Nice acting job there by Harris.
Sometimes it doesn't take much to fool these officials in high school level basketball.
I tell you, old Morton used to do that move a lot.
Yeah,
Kevin Morton,
did.
He would, every time he took a shot, if he thought he was going to miss it, he was falling down. Harris, it's hard to believe it's been, you know, 4 years since Morton played.
Yeah, and if you saw Morton these days, it might even be harder to believe it's been only 4 years. That wasn't very nice, was it?
Kevin was a good basketball player here
for
Prairie Grove. And talking about him, the first night I ever saw him play, he was playing over at Elkins, and he was a ninth grader.
Yeah.
And he was shooting about the fall.
Oh, I know.
And I was like, this kid's unbelievable.
Yeah. That day he and his mother came to Prairie Grove and said, we're thinking about transferring over here. I thought it was like a practical joke. I was like, no way.
Part of one of the great Prairie Grove. There's been some great Prairie Grove teams back. You know, I know when your brother played, they had some really good teams back
then. They did,
then. And also there's a nice shot by Ty Tice. No
oh
good.
Gosh,
nice rebound by Harton to back up and in.
Oh, Dowdy lost his balance.
Oh,
got lucky there.
He's falling again.
Yeah.
He's won that foul again. I told you, he got that got the Morton syndrome there. Brad, they're going to give Brad that shot. Ty's got to make one of these threes. Eventually,
there we
yes!
go.
There we go. That pulls us back within single digits, 45-36.
Hanging around, making sure we can just slow them down on defense.
Well, this has got to be a confidence builder in the sense that P. Ridge, one of the better teams in the conference, totally blown out by Shiloh. And that doesn't mean that still won't happen to us tonight, but it was hung around well. Harris gets the rebound, and now with 25 points, puts Shiloh back up by double digits. Delton's gotten a good rest.
Well, Lynn, you know you're a good player when you've only hit six shots, but you've got 25 points, and that's what Harris has done exactly. He's gotten a lot of points from the free throw line, hit a lot of threes, and usually on six made baskets, you're going to have 15, 16 points, but he's got 25.
You know what? When he does it, the thing is, three of those threes were turnaround jumper threes.
Yeah,
one of them was an NBA three. So, I mean, he's an incredible player. I'm extremely impressed with him. Tice driving the baseline. Finds Rhodes. I don't know if it's just me, but it just seems like the possession arrow just stays that other way, doesn't it?
It always seems that way. You're right.
I know it's not, but it just feels like it. Again, if you're watching, please go to the comments page. Let us know where you're watching from.
Well, Coach Elder's, I'd say, 80% right over there on that arrow, usually.
80.
There's a turnover.
Yep. Back court.
It's just four for Shiloh. They've done a really good job of protecting the ball, and we're up to 11.
And our turnovers have not, and if they've been evenly spread among players. I mean, sometimes you got a guy just the pressure. You know, they've had battles caught in the corner a couple times.
Yeah.
And Cameron's had a few turnovers, and you know, Tice has had a couple. Delton's had a couple. We've been evenly spread. Nice pass by Delton Rhodes. Nice unselfish play there. Nice play there by Delton. 47-38. Tigers hanging around.
Sticking with it. What were we down at halftime, Lynn? Do you remember the exact score? I failed to write it down.
We were down by nine at halftime.
Nine, okay. So we played him even this third quarter. Got a chance to cut into it here. Oh, good play.
Delton Rhodes with a chance. This is his, I believe, third 20-point game of the year. I think he had one of 23. You said he had a 25 against Batesville. He's sitting at 21 now.
Playing really well.
Four fouls on number 11, Andrew Daniels, who's come off the bench in different times tonight.
Yeah, Daniels is a pretty good defensive player, so that could hurt them a little bit if he's.
And Delton makes the free throw. Battles comes in for Rhodes. Smart move there by Coach Ed to keep Delton from picking up a cheap fourth foul in the last 48 seconds. Prairie Grove only down by six.
Yeah, and Dowdy, real key right here. You know they're probably going to try to go to Harris. We'll see if we can do a good job on him and not allow him to score here to end the quarter.
How many fouls Dowdy sitting on?
Dowdy has no fouls.
So he needs to be super aggressive
here. Yes, exactly.
Super aggressive here.
And the other guys are going to have to make sure they help if there's any kind of screen set for Harris at all.
Not sure I wouldn't let them run the clock off here just to preserve you know, our players, our fouls. We're down by six. If we can hold them here.
And we're down to 10 seconds, Lynn.
Yeah, Paulie has not – I don't think Paulie's taking a shot all night. They're trying to get it to Harris.
Stay up.
And Cameron did a nice job.
He did.
But he turned around. I've watched a lot of basketball in this gym and over the years. Very few players I see do turnaround jumpers from 3 points.
Yeah, you think about some of the great shooters that we've seen, you know, the Trumbo kids from Huntsville. I've never seen them just turn and shoot the ball like that without any kind of hesitation. And granted, he had to shoot the ball. They were down in the clock there. But he's done that before with the clock not winding down. He's taken the shot, just spun her and shot it. But, yeah, that was a good job by Dowdy there contesting that shot. If he would have made that shot, I'd say we have no chance to win this game.
Well, the possession arrow is in our favor.
Finally.
So we may have a chance here to cut the lead to four, possibly even three.
Yeah, this will be a big offensive possession for us. We've got the momentum coming into the fourth quarter. A shot here would be big to continue that momentum.
This team reminds me a lot of our 09 and our 08, 09 and our 09, 10 teams. They could show up one night and just play their tails off. A little bit of inconsistency among our team.
Yep.
But I know being down by six, you know, of course, you always want to win, but I know Coach Ed is probably pleased with the effort tonight that our team has played with.
Definitely. I think you've got to be pleased with effort. We've made some mental mistakes. It's going to happen in any game. Sometimes you make a few more of those than what you'd like to happen, but effort's been pretty good too.
Turnover there by Tice. He's trying to make a play.
And they gave it back to us.
12 turnovers tonight for Prairie Grove. Not exactly what you want, but could be worse. boy, they're really trapping us in those corners. But they, if whether it's Dowdy or Battles over there, they seem to really be.
Yeah, we can't keep the ball too long on those wings because they're running two guys at us at times.
Boy, three-point basket here. You might see the Prairie Grove crowd. There's two. I'll take a two-pointer. No good by Tice. Nice rebound. I know we don't keep up with all the rebounds, but Thompson's got to be
Thompson,
a double.
Double-double, yeah,
I'd double, say. Double-double tonight. And there's Harris. Definitely the basket goes in. 49-41. If he gets inside the paint, you might as well just go ahead and count it.
Yeah, even with the guy on him, he's able to rise up and shoot the ball over him. And I wouldn't be surprised to see Delton's in the game. I thought Delton was still on the bench. But wouldn't be surprised to see us go to Delton right here, see if he can get going again offensively. He's got 22 points on the night so far, so he's had the hot hand. We'll see if we can get him a good look coming out of this timeout. This is like retro night.
Yeah.
Here at Prairie Grove with the music playing.
Marnell.
Ask him who he'd like to see pound 33.
I don't know who can shoot over it.
I think he means just hammer it. Like, bring somebody like Martin in and just, you know.
Use 5 fouls.
All right. Prairie Grove down by 8. Still in this thing. We need a few. Wow. That was a long pass. Tice wanting the ball over there. Delton shoots over. And that's a nice, about a 8-foot jumper there by Delton Rhodes, now with 24 points.
Well, that's exactly what we needed coming out of that timeout. Get the ball to our best offensive player. He made a play for us.
Now another turnover by Shiloh. Delton wanting to make some. Oh, he got away with it. We'll take it. The lead down to 4.
Well, this is as close as we've been in a long time.
It's the closest we've been since the first quarter.
Yeah.
Nice pass, and you know, back up to 6. You know, Harris is a smart player.
Yep.
He knows when everybody picks him up, someone's going to be open.
Exactly. Our other defenders did a good job of helping out.
Tice for 3. Oh, nice sky and rebound by Rhodes. Turns it over, and now that was a nice rebound by Rhodes. It let it get away from him, and he slid across the floor.
Play's getting a little sloppy on both ends. Shiloh going to try to settle it down here.
Oh, that's again, like I said, Harris is just giving it up to Thompson underneath. I don't think Thompson's made a shot outside of 3 feet.
No, I don't think so either. It's all been layups for him, and that time Harris put him in an excellent position to get an easy basket again.
Back up to 8 is the lead. Prairie Grove got it down to 4. Oh, Bob Gardner. There's Tice for 3. Bottom!
There we go.
Yes! And now Coach Ed's going to take a full, and the lead is down to 5. How many timeouts? I think we've got 3 left.
I think you're right. I think that's only our second one, maybe our third one. And I wouldn't be surprised, Lynn, right here, if we see some maybe tweak defensively. Because it looks like Harris has figured out that box of one a little bit. So I think there will be some kind of adjustment defensively on this end of the floor for the Tigers.
It may be time definitely to start pressing a little bit.
Yeah, may see if they can handle the ball a little bit. We've not seen any press from either team.
Or at least pick them up at half court. Maybe,
pick them up, maybe a half court trap. We've got that in the playbook too, so. Yeah, I think there will be some kind of adjustment to see if we can slow down not only Harris but Thompson as well underneath the basket. You know, I've seen a triangle and 2 from Coach Ed as well, so that's an option maybe. Put somebody down there and keep somebody on Thompson to prevent him from getting those easy layups.
When I see Shiloh tonight and I watch them as a total team, I see Thompson and I see Harris. And that's not taking anything away from the other players. Those two guys are what make them click.
Well, we have changed defensively. Look at Delton. His man is still Harris, but he's not man-to-man. He's not right in his face like he was earlier. He's anticipating a screen, and right now there's not been any screen set for Delton.
Delton's with three fouls, so we're getting down to that point where he can be a little aggressive. Don't want him to pick up the fourth, but we're down to 4 minutes left, so he's got to try something here. Again, falling yet to take a shot. There's the shot. Three-pointer in and out by Anderson. Prairie Grove with the opportunity here. Delton wanting that shot. Don't turn it over. There we go. We got the ball back. Dowdy's got a three-pointer. He's open. Bottom! And Prairie Grove has pulled within two of the Shiloh Christian Saints.
Out of nowhere, Lynn.
And all of a sudden, the Shiloh fans are a little nervous.
And quiet, too. Well, Anderson got a good-looking three that last time. It just didn't fall down for him. He's hit a couple of those tonight.
Almost another turnover there by Shiloh.
Still a lot of ball game left, too.
I wouldn't be surprised if Coach Tester calls a timeout here in a minute to kind of make some adjustments to what's
either that or just sits on the ball, because we're not denying the ball from anybody other than Harris.
But I also think, and you know, Harris got a little impatient that time. And now, Prairie Grove inside, Patterson. Oh, Patterson had a chance there, rushed it a little bit.
Well, Marcus was anticipating contact right there, and Shiloh didn't touch him, and he overshot it.
And there's Coach Hester's calling that timeout. And you know, I'm okay with running down the clock and getting this down within two with a minute to go, because
you take your chances.
You take your chances, yeah, because I think the with a guy like Harris, their chances of scoring are better than ours every time you go down the court.
Right.
I mean, you know.
Yeah, and Delton has matched him point for point, but Delton doesn't have the size that Harris does. So they've got an advantage there when he's got the ball in his hands, as opposed to us when we've got Delton with the ball in our hands.
Well, the thing I would say with Delton versus is that Delton is a little streakier. He's playing extremely well tonight. Taking nothing away from Rhodes. But Harris is, I mean, he's a D1. He's a potential D1 player.
Yeah, he's all-around package. You can tell that for sure. He's got size. He can shoot it from outside, take you inside. He's a very good passer, too, as we've seen tonight. He's a good player. Let's see what Coach Hester decided to do coming out of this timeout.
And now a lot of fouls to give. Dowdy, that's his first, isn't it?
Yeah, first foul. That's not a bad foul either, because we may be put in a position where we have to foul, and we want him to be in the bonus. So we've got to be really aggressive here. We've still got three fouls to give.
Again, as long as we're only 2 points down, I don't care if another minute clicks off the clock, because all it takes is one turnover, and you're there. I think Coach Hester told him, you're not taking that three-pointer.
Right.
Because Anderson's had it a few times. And Tyson's being aggressive. 5 seconds, let's go, call it.
Yeah, nobody's even counting. No official was even counting on that play.
Thompson has been so consistent. Again, with another 3-foot basket all night.
We played a good defensive possession there, and then at the last minute, they found Thompson again for an easy layup.
Now we've got to be a little bit aggressive here. We're down to minute 46.
Still plenty of time. We need to get a good shot. Don't have to be too much of in a rush here. Be smart.
Dowdy for three. Wow.
A good rebound by Marcus, keeping it alive for us.
Excellent rebound. And he actually – we have Shiloh guy calling for 3 seconds, and I admit he was right. We had a guy kind of sitting down there for a while.
Well, if they don't call 5 seconds on one end, they're probably not going to call 3 seconds.
It's not speed unless you get caught.
That's right.
Bob Garner goes up strong, and he's going to get the foul. And Thompson turns around looking like The famous who, me?
Yeah. I think he thought he got a lot of ball on that play. He may have, but the official called that from behind.
Yeah. Well, I think regardless of how this finishes out, Bob Gardner, come on, you got to hit it. Regardless of how this finishes out, I think when the rest of the conference takes a look at the newspaper tomorrow and sees the score is going to be impressed with the Prairie Grove effort. And that's not to say we still can't pull this thing out.
Right, yeah. We're going to be a team that's going to scrap for a few wins, probably win a few games that maybe we shouldn't win talent-wise. But the effort's been really good tonight. And we've still got a chance to win this game if we can force a turnover right here, get a stop. And probably now, Lynn, would be the time where we're going to see a full court press.
Well, you got to take your chances now.
Yep.
I mean, it's,
yep.
They make it an easy basket, but you got to take your chances in.
And we've still got a lot of fouls to give, so we can be really aggressive with this full court press and try to force a turnover, because we're going to need to get that foul count up to the bonus in case we don't get a turnover. We're going to have to make them shoot free throws. And I'd say we want anybody to shoot it except Harris. If we're going to foul anybody, let's not foul him.
I'd like to see Thompson shoot outside of 2 feet. He might be a great free throw shooter.
Well, I'm like you. Let's find out.
And they get it to Harris. And that's what we're talking about.
Oh, there it was.
Basket.
Another easy one.
That's
18
okay.
points for Thompson.
Now we need a basket here. And a long three for Delton. Too long, I believe. Got a little impatient there. And we're going to get the foul. Delton may have been a little impatient. That was a long three-pointer there, Derek.
Yeah, we were going to have to get a quick shot. I don't know if necessarily that's the one that we needed to take, but, you know, Delton had an open look, and he's hit three or four of those three-point shots tonight, so maybe not the worst shot. And now we got to come foul, and we're still a foul away from making them shoot free throws.
We need to deny him the ball, though.
Exactly.
Eat too easily, and now they're going to be in the bonus.
Yeah, I would almost put two people on Harris to keep him from catching this ball.
He walked. Oh. I'm begging for something.
Are they going to give him two shots on that or just a one-on-one? They call it on the floor, hopefully.
I don't know if they're going to call on the floor or not.
Yep, one-on-one.
So they're gonna
maybe we'll get lucky right here.
The floor. Well, he's missed one free throw only tonight, and he makes the first. He stretches the lead to six, so still two possession game.
Yeah, he's 11 for 12 at the free throw line, 28 points on the night.
Now it's a three possession game. That's going to make it a little more difficult, but again, not insurmountable, but we got to strike and strike quick. Nice play, and Prairie Grove gets the timeout. Pulls within five. That was nice ball movement there.
Yeah, that was good execution. We worked quick and ended up getting a good layup. A good finish by Baumgartner down low. Pull it. All right, Lynn, we got to have a turnover. Got to force a turnover.
And we got to do it. And this is where I don't think you need to foul in the backcourt.
Not necessarily. I mean, you'd probably like to see them take a couple of dribbles before and maybe see if you can get a turnover off the dribble or off the pass. But not a whole lot of time where we can be.
Foul him. There we go.
Now
we'll get a chance to see. And Thompson may be a great free throw shooter. Has he gone to the line tonight?
He has not. But he's definitely seen the ball go in the basket enough tonight. 18 points. I think all 9 of his baskets have been right underneath the basket.
Do you know what Shiloh's record was coming in tonight?
I believe they were 9-6.
I
think
six are from
good competition. Yeah. You know, Jonesboro beat him pretty bad. Jonesboro is a 7A school.
Misses the first end of the 1-1.
I know they're 2-0 in conference, though.
Bob Gardner. Oh, and Bob Gardner's going to get called for a
jump ball.
And he calls the jump ball. I have to say, I'm even shocked. I almost have to apologize to the Shiloh fans for that call.
Oh, man.
I know we've always wanted to tackle them in football, so we just took it out here on the basketball court.
Wow.
Now they got working around. And now they get the ball in the hands of Harris. You know, that was our chance, Derek, down here.
I still can't get over that jump ball call. I mean, Baumgartner tackled the guy. Oh, my goodness.
When I saw the two thumbs go up, I was shocked.
Yeah, that's what I thought it was going to be, an intentional foul. Well, Harris has hit the 30-point mark.
Well, I will say as we go now, and it looks like Coach Ed brings Battles in. He's a little bit better outside shooter than –
yep.
Then Baumgartner going down the stretch here. Still down by 7, not insurmountable, but getting very close to, got to be a quick shot. Battles for 3, going to be short. And now that's probably going to do it. But it was a good game. Prairie Grove's going to fall to 1-2 in the conference. I believe Shiloh will move to 3-0 in the conference.
3-0, yep.
And the good sign here tonight is we play probably, if not the best team, one of the best teams in the conferences. A very good ball game tonight. Some bright spots. Harris is sitting at 32 points tonight. And that was with a box and one.
Yeah, I mean, he's only shot the ball 12 times from the field, but yet he's got 32 points going on 33 here. And when you can get that many easy shots at the free throw line,
He's sitting at 33. You've got Thompson Thompson ended up with 18.
18. You know, Harrison shot 17 free throws tonight.
Dalton, a long 3. No good. Down to 7 seconds. Battling for a rebound. Ty's going to throw up a 3, and he's going to be fouled. And he's going to get to go shoot 3 free throws. It'll look good for the paper if he can make all 3 of them. How many points is he sitting at?
Ty's tonight? Got 6 points. I think he hit 2 3-pointers for the night.
Well, the thing to do here would be if Shiloh's going to stay over there. Well, Shiloh's going to come out, looks like now.
Yeah.
I think going to stay over there, make the first 2, miss the 3rd one,
yep,
and get it even closer. But.
Well, one thing, Lynn, I think we shot 8 free throws in the first quarter, and from that point on we've only shot 5. So the aggressiveness hasn't been there. Offensively, we've done a good job. But just hadn't got to the free throw line enough tonight. Not nearly like Shiloh did.
Tice misses the 1st. Misses the 2nd. And looks like we're going to finish here at 63. I'm going to call it 63-55.
I think you're right.
Well,
oh, goodness.
We're going to get one more shot at the ball, and then Tice could have closed that with 6, but it looks like it's going to end with a 9-point loss. Delton Rhodes ends up with 26 points. And that's the ball game. Well, Derek, the final score. Prairie Grove Tigers lose a hard-fought battle to Shiloh Christian, 63-54. I think we played them even in the second half.
Yep. Was able to cut the lead to what? Did we tie it up there in the fourth quarter?
Yep.
Tied it up, just couldn't sustain it.
If you'll go through the stats real quick, we'll go ahead and get ready to sign off. Go ahead and go through the stats.
Okay, of course, Darian Harris led Shiloh with 33 points. He scored over half of their points tonight. Taylor Thompson with 18 points, Ryder Anderson with 9, Andrew Daniels with 2, and Hunter Pauling with 1 point. And then Delton Rose, maybe his best offensive output of the season. He had 26 points, but that's really not a good sign when he scored half of our points. We just didn't get enough around him to really be able to finish in the fourth quarter. Baumgartner had 8. Ty Tice, Cameron Dowdy, and Marcus Patterson all ended up with 6 points, and then Bradley Harton came in and got 2 points off the bench. You go Rhodes, Steak and Shake, player of the game tonight.
I would definitely have to go with him tonight. I mean, he played hard. He made a lot of big shots, and definitely Delton Rhodes, our Steak and Shake player of the game. Well, this Friday, we are scheduled to do the Gentry game. There has been a change, however, because of the Arkansas Cotton Bowl game against Kansas State. The two teams, two schools, have decided to play early. They'll start at 4 o'clock. Watch PGTigersOnline.com. We may not do that game. It may be hard to get there in time for that, but watch PGTigersOnline.com for our ability to be able to do that game. Well, again, good night tonight. Our girls, both the junior high girls and senior high girls, defeat Shiloh fairly handily, and both of our boys played very good foot basketball games and fall just a little short. Well, that's it. We want to thank our cameraman tonight, Doug Smith. We appreciate him tonight for coming and helping us out. Derek, we'll see you again soon. I'm Lynn Gretchen. That's it for tonight, and we will see you next time for Prairie Grove Tiger Basketball.